Republican chair of the House Oversight Committee, James Comer, finally got his hands on the precious, unredacted Biden emails that he was salivating over as part of his possible impeachment investigation. And I say possible because, you know, to bring forth an actual impeachment, you need some evidence, but they're falling short. All he learned was that some Georgian women think the president is a zaddy. Not the information he was looking for. So let's talk about what was actually in the emails. So the emails from the time, these emails are from the time that President Joe Biden was vice president. So this is during the Obama administration. In July 24th, 2009, in one of those emails that was forwarded by Biden's then personal assistant to Biden and his two sons, it included praise for a speech Biden had delivered in Tbilisi to the Georgian parliament. The assistant forwarded the email titled Biden as new Georgian sex symbol, and with the following commentary, must read email below. It also stated that multiple female friends were talking about how sexy Biden was after his visit. A new man in my life, remarked one. A big crush on him, said another. To which I say, maybe the investigation should be into these women who somehow find Biden attractive.
Yeah, Biden was about to get me too'd over there. Lord have mercy. I can't believe it. Somebody okay. gotta get HR on the horn over there, because these women, they're too horny. My word.
So think about that in the context of Joe Biden and just mine, like, honestly, it's the most interesting thing that has come out of this investigation. I got to be honest. So you know what, Comer, go for it. Keep investigating. Maybe we'll find some more juicy tidbits. Now, a July 14th, 2016 schedule card shows that Biden was to meet with the prime minister of Ukraine. Oh, I bet that was a juicy one, right? The newly unredacted portion show that he was also scheduled to work out with his personal trainer and dine with Hunter's then 15-year-old daughters Maisie and Finnegan in the vice president's office. Again, not exactly what Comer was hoping to find. Also, a May 27th, 2016 schedule card includes a call with former Ukrainian president Petro Poroshenko. Hunter Biden was copied on the day's schedule. It's already been reported that Biden was also due to attend the one-year anniversary of the passing of his son, Beau, back home in Delaware. Now, Comer, this is my favorite part, okay? Comer had been pointing to this scheduling item since it was also emailed to then Vice President Biden under a pseudonym email address. Comer even said the vice president was sending a secret message to his son that he was about to fire the prosecutor, meaning the Ukrainian prosecutor Shokin. We'll get to him in just a moment. As recently as last week, Comer included that email on a list of evidence of Joe Biden's involvement in his family's influence peddling schemes. However, the Washington Post had debunked this a few weeks ago by noting that Parliament had fired the prosecutor 2 months prior to Hunter Biden being looped on the day's itinerary. The only new information in the unredacted version was a phone number of an aide. That was it. Okay, and the other thing I'll say is, I've been trying to figure out how exactly are conservative commentators still hanging on to evidence of wrongdoing, evidence of criminality, right? Like, well, what are they saying to their audiences? And believe it or not, they are pointing to former Hunter Biden business partner Devin Archer's testimony, in which he simply said that sometimes when Hunter Biden was in the presence of business partners, his father would call him to say hello and check in on him. And because of that, there is now proof that Joe Biden was involved in the business dealings of Hunter Biden, because he called his son to say hello. And that was it. I mean, Devin Archer testified that Joe Biden had nothing to do with any of the business deals, any of the negotiations. He would be shocked if that were the case. That was what he testified. But he did say that sometimes, because Joe Biden hasn't memorized his son's schedule, he would call his son as his son happened to be meeting with business partners. That's what they're hanging their hat on. It's amazing.
As evidence, smoking gun, evidence. As long as they say all the, you know, the spark and the emotional words that get people then go, oh my God, what did they just said? Must have been, I was snoozing during it, but they just said smoking gun. So I think I just heard a smoking gun. That's the process and that's the approach that it's been. How many times has James Comer and Jim Jordan put themselves on television or in hearings and embarrassed themselves like this? At some point, at least just wait. Because I actually, you know, since this whole thing started, I was like, man, these are some clowns. I wonder when they stumble across and reveal some actual information that shows some wrongdoing. Maybe won't go to the degree of total corruption and was handing over trade secrets over a couple dollars for his son or snorting lines of coke, whatever it is that they're saying was happening. I'm still waiting for some of it. I was like, they must have started this because something happened. I actually believed there's probably 5% of something they're saying that did happen, and I'm still waiting for it. I'm ready. I got a tall glass of conspiracy ready to drink this, and they haven't given it to me yet. I'm sure people that are actually supportive of these guys are really waiting for it. Bro, if you got it, we're ready for it. And they still haven't come up with it. What's the plan, bro? What's the plan?
So there are reports that they're getting a lot of pressure from Donald Trump to pursue this impeachment, even though they have absolutely no evidence. And I mean, look, they're really playing with fire here because it's not just Trump, to be fair. Republican voters are like urging and pressuring Republican lawmakers to pursue this investigation. But at the end of the day, the election is going to, this is a politicized stunt, right? And at the end of the day, elections come down to independent voters. And so if after several years of this investigation, the House Oversight Committee under the leadership of James Comer and the Republican Party come up with nothing, well, then you're going to turn a lot of independents off. And even J.D. Vance is saying that. J.D. Vance is like, I don't know, this is not a good idea. This could actually really hurt us in the next election. We'll see what happens. But in regard to the prosecutor, in case some of you don't know about this angle or forgot about it. So Republicans have been arguing essentially that Joe Biden fired a prosecutor who was investigating the Ukrainian gas company Burisma, which Hunter Biden was serving on. And the whole idea was, oh, there was corruption on the board, there was corruption with this gas company, and Trump and Biden as VP decided to fire the prosecutor in order to end that investigation. But that is not the case. So it turned out that Shokin himself was corrupt. He actually was not investigating Burisma. And Biden didn't unilaterally make a decision to do away with him. This was the current US foreign policy at the time. And so he carried out US foreign policy on behalf of the United States government. Whereas if you look at Trump's first impeachment, he was withholding congressionally appropriated money to Ukraine unless Volodymyr Zelensky announced a sham investigation into Joe Biden to help him, help Trump get a leg up in the 2020 presidential election. That's what he got impeached for. So if you're trying to compare the two investigations, we're talking about two very, very different situations. So far, there hasn't been any evidence of Biden engaging in any wrongdoing. Now, with that said, Comer is now arguing, look, anyone who thinks that we're worth laughing at, just keep in mind that we haven't gotten all the documents we asked for. There might be more. So this is what he says. Yeah. A House Oversight Committee spokesperson said to Politico, "It's silly for anyone to try to draw conclusions from 14 pages of documents that the White House cleared to give to Congress, especially when it contains an email that opines on foreign nationals thinking Joe Biden is sexy." These are the emails Joe Biden wants Americans to see. I bet he does. I think that's probably the most accurate thing this person is saying. The Oversight Committee will continue to follow the money and evidence to hold President Biden accountable for his abuse of public office. You guys go ahead and do that. But remember, Comer received the specific document, unredacted, that he had asked for. The document that he believed was going to prove that Joe Biden was engaged in wrongdoing, and it proved no such thing. So, I mean, look, great, let's give them more unredacted documents if they want. But I think they're starting to realize there's no there, and it could backfire politically. Any final words on this?
I got one. Just like,
Would just like to thank Comer for making me feel personally closer to Joe Biden and Hunter Biden, because anybody who has immigrant parents has had the experience of getting a phone call in the middle of the day on a weekday and your parent being shocked that you are at work. What? You're working? No way. Like, bruh. It's Tuesday at 1:30. What else would I be doing? So yeah, thank you for that, Comer.
One time my mom called me in the middle of the workday to tell me about like a designer purse that she thinks I should buy as she was at the mall. And I'm like, Mom, I don't do designer purses. It's going to be all right. Don't call me about this kind of stuff. Anyway, but yeah, it's true. By the way, parents call randomly all the time, right? Like the idea that Joe Biden calling his son is enough evidence to point to wrongdoing.
The family values party, Anna.
Yeah. It's insane. Any final words, JR, before we wrap up?
Oh, yeah. Really fast. Yeah. Just so this seems like the objective maybe for Comer and these guys is to keep this going for the duration, this until the next election cycle, and then hopefully have this energy of lawlessness surrounding Joe Biden's name be the thing. And then that derails hopefully him for the next election. But the thing is, this is way too long. We're already tired of it. The people that are supporting you are already tired of it. If we stretch this all the way to the next election, it's going to be like, okay, bro, cool. What now? The strategy is way off if that's it. Or the other part of it being, let's cover for all of Donald Trump's potential criminality because of all the indictments on him. We need to at least have both of them are up on all kinds of investigations. Whichever reason it is, it ain't working, bro. And it's really hard to pull the emergency pull handle now because that looks even worse. So I think he's now beholden to something he started that he probably doesn't want to keep doing.
Look, we all run into issues in our lives. It's all about how we react or respond to those issues. Compounding the problem isn't usually the best avenue, but who knows? Maybe Comer knows better than us. We'll see.
If you enjoyed this video, that's because of our members. They make us independent, they make us strong, and they make us honest. Become a member today by hitting the join button below.